friends, today we are going to see pumping lemma theorem. Pumping lemma theorem is used to tell us given language is not regular. So here these are the some conditions. First we will see which languages are regular and which are not regular. A star, B star, this language is regular. Why? Because this we can represent with the help of finite automata. Again, A star plus B, C star plus C, or whole bracket star, like this. All these languages are regular language because we can represent these languages with the help of finite automata. But if A raised to N, B raised to N, this is one more regular expression. A raised to N, B raised to N, which we cannot represent with the help of finite automata because this is not a regular language. Why? Here, if you observe A raised to N and B raised to N, this N and this N is same. This statement and this statement is not same. Both are different statement. So, A raised to N, B raised to N. Let us consider A raised to 3, B raised to 3. This string is accepted by using this expression. Same, this string is accepted by this regular expression. But A raised to 3, B raised to 5, this string can be accepted by using this expression, but this string cannot be accepted using this expression. Why? Because there is a N is a same number. So this same number we cannot represent with the help of finite automata because finite automata is not having own memory to store how many times this A is already taken. That's why this is the limitation of finite automata. This string we can accept using pushdown automata. Pushdown automata we are going to see in detail. So A raised to 3, B raised to 5, which we cannot accept using A raised to N, B raised to, but which we can accept using A star, B star. So this is a non-regular language. This is not a regular language, but this is a regular language. So pumping lemma theorem tell us only given language is not regular. Now here we can see, let L be a regular language, any regular language, and M is our finite automata. With the help of that finite automata, we can represent that language with N number of steps. Now here, there are the three conditions for pumping lemma. Omega, let us consider omega is a string which belongs to L, and length of omega means length of that omega is less than or equal to N. So we will see with the help of example in detail. So first condition, y is greater than 0. Mod of y means length of y is greater than 0. Second condition is mod of xy is less than or equal to N. So this is length of this x and y. Again, x, y raised to I, z belongs to L. So this is a whole regular expression. So this regular expression belongs to L, where I is greater than or equal to 0. Here this y is going to be repeated. Okay, we are pumping it. Now these statements we can represent with the help of this finite automata. So this x is nothing but there are many states which represent x. There are again many states over there. There is a loop or self loop like that. And here is a z. So again these are the combination of states. So x, number of states. Again there are number of states and their number of states. So these states we can represent with the help of this expression. X, y raised to I, z. So y raised to I is a pumping, means repeated. Now here we will see with the help of example. This language is not a regular language. L is equal to A raised to N, B raised to N. N is greater than 0. We know first statement. First statement is that, first we'll consider this language is a regular language. So we will assume given language is a regular language and which we can represent with the help of finite automata with N number of states. N number of states. So this is our first statement. Now second statement, and we will contradictory prove it. Now second statement is length of this language. Length we can show with the help of W. W is a language. So a raised to n, b raised to n. So length of a raised to n, b raised to n is equal to 2n, which is greater than n. So as per pumping lemma, your language should have length greater than n. This is our second statement. Now third statement. We know pumping lemma theorem. In pumping lemma theorem, there are three regular expression x, y, z. So mod of y should be greater than 0, first statement. Then mod of x, y should be less than or equal to n. Means length of this x, y should be less than or equal to n. And we can prove it for this pumping. Means x, y raised to I, z, where I is greater than or equal to 1, or the I is greater than 0. So we will prove right now this a raised to n, b raised to n is x, y, z language. So length of this one is 2n. Now if I am going to take I is equal to 2, what will happen? We will check one by one. So first language is x, y, z, which is a raised to n, b raised to n, which I am going to represent in this way. A raised to n minus 2, a raised to 2 and b raised to n. This statement and this statement is same. Only a raised to n minus 2 minus a raised to 2. In this way we have written. So this statement is nothing but a raised to n, b raised to n. Now this statement we can represent in the form of x, y, z. So this is my x expression, this is my y expression, this is my z expression. So if I took I is equal to 2, I is equal to 2, my expression will become x, y raised to 2, z. X, y raised to 2, z. Now we will put y, I raised to 2, means I is equal to 2 in this regular expression. So x is nothing but a raised to n minus 2, y raised to 2, means I is equal to 2. So a raised to 2 raised to 2, and then b raised to n as it is. So this expression will become a raised to n minus 2, then a raised to 4, b raised to n. So this is nothing but a raised to n plus 2, b raised to n. A raised to n plus 2, b raised to n. For x, y raised to 2, z, this expression is a raised to n plus 2, b raised to n, which is not equal to our given language a raised to n, b raised to n. Because over there is a extra 2. Means this language is not equal to this language. So contradictory, we prove that this x, y raised to 2, z does not belong to given language a raised to n, b raised to n. So here we can write, in contradiction, given language is not a regular language. Given language L is equal to a raised to n, b raised to n, where n is greater than 0, is not a regular language. In this way we can prove.
Thank you. If you like this video, click on like button and do not forget to subscribe the channel. Click on bell button to get notification of new video. Thank you.